There are more than 3,500 species of mosquitoes living on Earth. Some of them drink blood, and others are carriers of dangerous diseases. But people never interact with most representatives of the mosquito family. And these unique insects survived the dinosaurs and adapted to the appearance of mammals and humans. In the process of their development, mosquitoes have gone through very difficult paths, developing many unique adaptations for successful existence. And in this video, we're going to help explain the evolutionary process of the mosquito. By subscribing to the Age of Dinosaurs channel, you can learn about different species of modern or extinct animals. Comments and likes help promote the videos according to the platform's algorithms. Therefore, we encourage our viewers to more actively express their opinions about the work of the channel's creators. The very first mosquitoes were very different from the bloodsuckers we're used to. These were primitive insects that fed on plant foods. It's believed that the first mosquitoes appeared more than 200 million years ago. They had a dense body covered with small hairs. They also had 6 legs and 2 pairs of wings. These wings were shorter than those of modern mosquitoes and lacked texture. They were not yet the blood-sucking insects. Even the structure of the oral apparatus did not allow them to pierce the skin of animals. They first developed a small proboscis to obtain the necessary saccharides and other substances from nectar and fruits. Scientists associate the sharp leap in the development of mosquitoes with the appearance of the first mammals. It was much easier to pierce the thin skin than the skin of the dinosaurs and other reptiles. And the substances necessary for the development of offspring turned out to be much easier to obtain from the blood of warm-blooded animals. Over millions of years of further development, their body has perfectly adapted to this method of reproduction. Another impetus for expanding the habitat and diversity of mosquito species was the appearance of humans. Over time, certain species of mosquitoes have appeared that drink only human blood. They've even changed their preferences in choosing housing. Most mosquitoes prefer to settle near natural bodies of water. But among modern species, there aren't exclusively urban residents. Probably their ancestors adapted to laying eggs in puddles and various reservoirs. It's possible that barrels containing drinking water were also used for these purposes. Such mosquitoes spread around the world with the help of ships on which people move between continents. Now, urban mosquitoes live in basements and other shady, damp places. They can hunt their prey even on sunny days, making short forays into the open. While in a forest or in a river, you can often see swarming mosquitoes. In urban areas, this phenomenon is now very rare. During the swarming process, a partner for mating is selected. The basements of a multi-story building are warm and humid almost all year round. These conditions are ideal for mosquito breeding. Therefore, urban species of mosquitoes have learned to lay eggs up to 3 times a year. At the same time, they don't need to gather in a swarm. It is believed that during the time of the dinosaurs, mosquitoes were much larger than their modern descendants. They could reach up to 10 centimeters in length. The body of prehistoric mosquitoes were wider and had a bigger wing shape. At the same time, they already fed on blood of larger animals. These mosquitoes did not pierce the victim's skin, but made small bite marks. At the same time, they themselves were an important part of the food chain and served as food for small reptiles. The most unique structural feature of mosquitoes, of which they had required over the millions of years of evolution, is their mouthparts. This primarily applies to females of those species that require several milliliters of blood for reproduction. Males obtain enough energy for their life activities by feeding exclusively on the nectar of various plants. Females are also able to feed on nectar, but they can lay eggs only after sucking blood. The mosquito does not pierce, but rather saw through the skin with a small tooth file. Its proboscis is a complex structure placed in a common case. In addition to the file, this tool includes spacers for expanding the wound, a thin proboscis, and a pump for suction. Mosquitoes also inject their saliva into the puncture. It contains substances that prevent blood clotting. They are also the ones who cause subsequent itching in the bite area. This property of mosquito bites in most cases is one of the most unpleasant consequences of meeting female mosquitoes. But in some cases, pathogenic microorganisms can enter the bloodstream along with mosquito saliva. They can cause serious diseases. Moreover, different types of mosquitoes are carriers of different diseases. For example, human malaria is transmitted only by a few dozen species of the genus Anopheles, or the malaria mosquito. They all live in different regions of the African continent. About 400 other species of malaria mosquitoes either do not transmit the disease or do not feed on human blood at all. These mosquitoes can also be a source of the canine parasite heartworm. But it's not dangerous for humans. True, some other animals, after being bitten by a malarial mosquito, can become intermediate carriers of pathogenic microorganisms. Malaria mosquitoes can be distinguished by the black spots on their wings. Also, the length of their proboscis coincides with the length of the probes. Female mosquitoes of this genus are capable of laying eggs in both fresh and salt water. As they grow, they go through the same stages as other mosquito species around the planet. First, the eggs hatch into larvae. They feed on underwater plants and microorganisms. At the same time, mosquito larvae breathe atmospheric air and often rise to the surface of the reservoir. They have a large head and a segmented body. They have no legs. To move, they use body movements or oral brushes. During the growth of the organism, the larvae molts three times, completely getting rid of the external skeleton. The next stage of mosquito development is the pupae. They have a comma-shaped body. The cephalothorax is located in the upper part. The abdominal region tapers downward. The mosquito pupae do not feed, but they also breathe air, floating to the surface. Development from egg to adult, depending on the type of mosquito and living conditions, can last from 7 to 14 weeks. Yellow fever biter and tiger mosquitoes from the Aedes aegyptian family are carriers of several life-threatening diseases. This could be a symptom of Zika, dengue fever, or yellow fever. In addition, they carry eggs of worms from heartworm family that parasites the human body. Initially, they lived only in Africa, but now they live mainly in the tropics and subtropics. They can also be found in colder regions around the world, except Antarctica. Now, they are a permanent resident of the European part of Russia, as well as territories of Ukraine and Belarus. The body length of the yellow fever mosquito can range from 4 to 7 millimeters. They're colored black with white stripes on the bodies and legs. The body of these mosquitoes have an elongated shape with thin legs ending in small, sharp claws. Their wings, covered with scales, are transparent. Mosquitoes are a great example of evolution at work. Since the age of dinosaurs, they have been improving their bodies and adapting to changing living conditions. Despite their small size, mosquitoes are one of the most successful creatures inhabiting our planet. In the process of their development, some of them acquired a narrow specialization and conquered almost all continents. Mosquitoes survived dinosaurs and adapted to live alongside humans. Perhaps millions of years from now, they will cause inconvenience to some other creatures who think that they are masters of the planet. We thank the viewers who watched this video to the end. If you want to learn more about the origin of other living beings, we recommend that you pay attention to our previous videos. Our channel also discusses issues related to the problems of modern ecology and human society.